Dear CG thinkers, welcome! Today we're diving into texturing in Blender using my add-on Materializer. We're going to take a little bit of altitude and create a beautiful render of a planet. Maybe a blue icy one or an orange desert planet if you prefer that warm and sandy vibe. The choice is yours. It might give your GPU a bit of workout. If it's been taking a nap lately, well, these should wake it up. Alright, let's start by selecting the principled BSDF, and we add a layer system to it. Now, in the grunge section of the Materializer library, choose the node called grunge 10, and connect it to the color input of the first layer. Since the surface of a planet doesn't surely reflect much light, we set the roughness to 1. Good. Now, for the first customization step, we add a color ramp node. On screen, you can see the gradient setup I'm using. It goes from white to dark blue, passing through this kind of icy blue in the middle. That gives the planet a frozen, cold atmosphere. But if you are more in the Mars team, no worries. Just add a Hue Saturation Value node, set the Hue value to 0.95, and just like that, your ice world turns into a warm desert planet. Pretty cool, right? You can simply mute or unmute that node to switch between the two versions whenever you want. Simple, clean, and super efficient. Now, let's add some variation to the planet's surface, inspired by what we can see on our own Earth, like the polar ice caps. In other words, the poles look brighter, and we are going to reproduce that effect here. So, let's start simple. Add a texture coordinate node, and from the object output, drag a link and drop it to add a separate XYZ node. Then, take the Z output and connect it to a math node. Set that one to absolute. Press Ctrl, Shift and left click on the node to preview the result. You will see a gradient going from black to white, from the equator all the way to the poles. Now let's control that gradient. Press F, go into the Math submenu and choose Shift Sharpen. This node lets you move and stretch the black and white areas. In my case, values around 0.08 and 0.77 work really well. Next, add a color mix node. Set it to color dodge. And use it to brighten the poles. By adjusting the black and white map, you can fine-tune how strong that brightening effect is. It gives a really nice natural look. Try muting the node for a second to see the before and after. You will really notice the difference. And for those who are working on the orange planet version, it works perfectly there too. Now, you might notice that I rearrange my node automatically. That's thanks to a small but super handy add-on called Node Arrange. It's free. I don't even remember where I downloaded it, but it's easy to find online and totally worth installing. Let's keep going with this idea of temperature gradients and make the planet's color change slightly depending on the latitude. To do that, we are going to add another Shift Sharpen node just after the absolute node. This time, use slightly different values, around 0.29 and 0.38. Now, duplicate the Hue Saturation Value node and place it right after the color ramp. We will make a very subtle adjustment to the Hue and Saturation, just enough to give the planet a colder, more icy tone. Then, connect the output of the Shift Sharpen node to the FAC input of the Hue Saturation Value node. That way, the color change will depend on how far you are from the equator. And again, it works perfectly for the orange version of the planet too. Alright, last thing for the surface. Lakes. Go to the space section of the Materializer library and select the Planet Lakes node. Connect the color output to the color input of your second layer and the mask output to the mask input of the Mix Layers node. Now, to actually see something, you need to connect the output of Grunge 10 to the planet surface input. You can play with the seed value to find the lake pattern you like best. In my case, I'm using 11.11. A few notes about this node. The coverage slider controls how large the lake areas are. Try not to make them too big, otherwise you will start getting continents. And since our brains are used to geography of Earth, it will look strangely fake. The color offset slider moves the color gradient, which is made of beige for sand, light blue for shallow water, and dark blue for deep water. I like to keep the default setting. It keeps the gradient nice and subtle. You can also tweak the color around the lake edges using the color variation mask output. Combine it with a mix color node, a color mix node set to U, and once again, keep it subtle. Just a slight color shift around the weight areas. And if you're working on the orange planet, you might want to switch to a warmer tone, something more yellowish or sandy. Now, it's time to add a bit of atmosphere, literally. We will add the atmosphere, the clouds, and a nice little bonus, auroras. Start by selecting and showing the sphere that will serve as the atmosphere. In its material, add the node Planet Atmosphere from the space section. Connect it directly to the volume output of the material. If you're using my starter file, the render settings are already set up. If not, no worries, take a quick look at them. And if you have seen my previous video, you will recognize this setting right away. If you haven't, I recommend watching it. It explains how volumetric rendering works in cycles, so everything will make sense. Now, how do we use this node? First, check your planet's size. Mine is 2 meters in diameter, which means 1 meter in radius. So I will set 1 in the second slider. For the atmosphere thickness, I'm using 0.03, and that's it. Nothing more to do here. Now, let's move on to the clouds. You will find the node in the same space section. Connect its volume output to the volume output of the material. Just like we did for the atmosphere. The setup is almost identical. You will just need to specify the same planet radius, which is still 1 in my case. To combine the two effects, add an Add Shader node. Now, for one last beautiful detail, auroras. You will find the Aurora Borealis node again in the space section. Duplicate the Add Shader node to mix this effect with the previous ones. But for performance reasons, we will only connect the auroras directly to the material output for now. Trust me, your computer will thank you for it. You can tweak the color if you want. I will just make a few small changes. Adjust the atmosphere thickness so it matches the other shaders, rise the altitude a bit, set the scale to 2, and the latitude limit around 0.92. At the bottom of the node, you will see two options. Only north. It lets you choose whether the auroras appear only at the north pole or at both poles. Style, it switches between two visual styles of auroras. So far, I've been working on the blue version of the planet. But if you want to switch to the orange version, you just reactivate the Hue Saturation Value node and tweak the color around the lakes to match the new atmosphere. Super quick, super easy. So, what about you? Blue planet or orange planet? I'm curious, tell me in the comments what you choose. That's it for today, thanks a lot for watching, and we will see you soon for another video. And remember, we get tired of everything, except learning. Bye bye.